Hey guys, Stacy Coward, and today I want to talk to you about you get what you pay for. If you have ever wondered why your life was going in a certain direction and you couldn't quite figure out what you're doing wrong, you may be feeling frustrated or angry or depressed or just like you just can't get it together. I want you to ask yourself this question: what am I paying for? And oftentimes we think about that. We think about, you know, what am I paying for? I get what I pay for in terms of it being something tangible, like a piece of furniture that's, you know, cheap or a car that's not quite working. But I want you to consider it from this perspective. When you pay for something, that means what are you putting your time, effort, energy, money, love, peace, what are you paying into every day? Where are you taking your energy and paying into every day? When you go to make a purchase in the store, you go in the store and you buy a particular thing. It could be orange juice, apple juice, soda. It could be anything. It could be something from 99¢ to $4.99 for just a drink. You'll get what you pay for out of those drinks. If you pay for the 99-cent drink, guess what? You'll feel like a 99-cent drink. If you pay for the drink that costs $4.49 scent because it's the naked with all the nutrition and nutrients in it, that's what you'll feel like at the end of the day. So what are you taking your energy and paying into? You know, the universe has a way of giving you exactly what you pay for. So if you pay for things that are good and lovely and peaceful and kind, guess what? You end up with a good and a lovely and kind and peaceful atmosphere and lifestyle. But if you pay into things that are angry and negative and frustrated, then that's the atmosphere you'll begin to live in. So what does it look like when you're paying for things? Paying for things is you're paying with your time. Where did you put your time today? Did you pay your time in listening to negative music or positive music? Did you wake up and listen to something inspirational, or did you wake up and listen to something that told you how bad things were, how bad people were? Did you pay into an environment, or did you pay your body with friends that speak life into you, or did you pay your body and your energy with people who speak death into you? What did you pay into today? You are paying for something every single day. You get what you pay for. Learn how to stop paying for things that you don't want. If you don't want it, don't pay for it. If you don't want to be over there, don't make a deposit into these arenas. Everything happens first in the spirit realm, and then it happens in the natural realm. If you want to know why your natural realm is operating the way that it is, ask yourself, what have I made spiritual payments into that's got me in this place? I don't want to be here anymore. How can I make deposits in other places? You know, all this stuff where they talk about pay it forward, do unto others, sow into good seeds. Believe it or not, those are all biblical principles that the world has taken and they're using them. And so now they're paying into places and allow and able to do great things because they understand the principles of sowing good seeds. So you have to learn how to pay into your lifestyle, pay into your dreams, pay into where you are trying to go. If you see somebody that looks really good or is doing really well, pay into them. Say to them, you know what? You are doing really, really good. Even if you give them a compliment, you're paying into them because you're paying into their life by speaking positive words into them. You may even want to say, let me buy your dinner today. You're paying into something that you want to become. Learn how to pay into those things that you are wanting to become, that you need to learn from. Pay into your future. Pay into your education. Pay into, and when I say pay into it, I'm not talking about money. Not necessarily. I'm talking about how do you pay into things with, you know, your mouth? How do you pay into things with your thoughts? How do you pay into things with your actions? You pay into things by being kind and courteous to the next person that's in front of you. That's how you make a payment on your children's future. You pay into things by thinking about others before you think about yourself. You pay into things by doing for other people. And you hear me saying it's a lot about doing and doing and doing. A lot of the things that you are doing are creating payments in the atmosphere. If you think about, why is my life not going where I want it to go? Well, where are you spending your time? Are you spending your time reading books? Are you spending your time playing PlayStation games or Xbox games? Are you spending your time getting high, smoking weed? I'm just telling the truth now. I'm telling the truth. Where are you paying your time? Or are you paying your time getting up in the morning and saying, let me see what I can pay into my future today. Let me hurry up and get in place. Let me hurry up and do some things that are going to make an investment in my future. Have I signed up for school? Did I run over there and see what I can get taken care of, taken off of my credit today? Have I called somebody and said, I cannot afford to pay this bill, come get this? What have I paid into to establish myself in a good credit realm? What, and when I say credit, I'm not even talking about credit like you see it in a natural realm. I'm talking about credit in the spiritual realm, credit where you're paying into other people, where you're investing in people outside of yourself, outside of your family, outside of those people that, you know, you automatically have to take care of. Pay into somebody that doesn't even know who you are. You know, do something. It's okay for you to give a dollar to the homeless person. That's a good thing. But I want you to be mindful too that you have to pay upward. What that means is you want to pay towards people that you want to be involved in. So if you look at somebody and say that they have a beautiful home, well, you want to pay into them. What that mean is you want to go over and you say, hey, can I hang out with you? You know, can I spend some time with you? Hey, let me come over and help you to straighten up something. Let me help you to hang your curtains or hang your pictures, or let me help you to build your deck. Let me pay into this lifestyle because this is what I want for my life. I remember looking at a couple that had been married for 50 plus years or so. And they were a beautiful couple and they loved each other and they were elderly together and they still were both respected and moving around very well. And I paid into them. I said, let me, I had an opportunity to sow a seed. So I sowed a seed into their marriage because that's what I want. I want to be able to look around and say, I've been married to my husband 50 years. So I paid into where I want to be. Wherever you want to be, you pay into that level. I brought up the difference between paying into the homeless person and paying into a higher level. Wherever you pay into, your gift makes room for you. So if you pay into a higher level, that level is going to make room for you, and then you're going to be able to step up into that level. If you pay into a lower level, and i.e. if you keep giving your money away to the wrong people and sowing your time into the wrong people and your energy into the wrong people, then you're going to make room down there for you. So you want to make room higher than you are. So you want to pay into areas that are higher into you. I pay for many, many things. And when I say pay, remind you, I'm not talking about money. Those things that I've paid for, I've had to have some valuable life lessons in those things that I paid for. But, and I had to make a decision about, did I want to continue to pay over here in this area? Many times you may be paying with your energy. You may be paying with your time. You may be paying with your resources. It's nothing to do with money, just you're paying though. And as you are paying into these places, know that these places you are paying into, you're going to get what you pay for. So if you pay up there, that's what you're going to get. If you pay down there, that's what you're going to get. If you pay sitting in front of the Xbox in the video game and getting high, that's what your life's going to look like. So you need to learn how to pay for what you want to be. You pay what you get. Whatever you getting is what you are currently paying for. So I want to encourage you today to start paying into places that you want to receive a benefit from. Make a conscious effort to look around and say, I want to be here in my life in 1 year. What do I have to do to get here? Pay over there. Pay in school. Pay with your education. Pay with your time. Pay with your resources. Pay to be in those circles. What I mean, now I am talking about payment now. Actually, pay for a workshop. Pay for a seminar. Pay for the classes that you need to go into. And let me say this. Everything free ain't free. Just because it's free, it doesn't mean that it's free. Some of this stuff that people are getting for free, you ought to say, you can keep that check. I don't want that check. Because if you pay me this check, that means you lock me into this realm, and I don't want to be in this realm of poverty. You can keep your stuff. Now look, I don't have no issue with food stamps. Been there, done that. If you need them, you need it. But I'm talking about them people driving them Hummers on food stamps. You wrong. Because you driving a Hummer and you live and you on food stamps and you can't understand why your life is not doing well. It's because you are allowing yourself to be paid in a inch down into a realm that keeps you there. You know, we had to get to the point where we say, all money ain't good. You can keep that because now you paying me to keep me someplace I don't want to be. And I would rather pay up so I can keep it moving. But that's another story, and we'll move on from there, and we will get to where we need to be, which is I want you to learn how to pay for what you want. And remember, everything free ain't free. And you get exactly what you pay for. So the next time that you are making deposits with your time, your energy, your money, your mouth, your resources, all of that stuff, ask yourself, am I paying for where I want to be? And if you're not paying for where you want to be, start paying for something else. I hope this information has helped you to retool your life. If you like it, subscribe, pass it on, and we'll see you next time.